under federal law, you can be convicted of the crime of conspiracy, even if the crime you're conspiring to commit would be impossible to do. I'm Andrew Williams, and this is another edition of The Fedora Lawyer. This is where you can find answers to questions about criminal court proceedings, answers to questions about what happens on your first day of court, how does probation work, the difference between a bench trial and a jury trial, how to erase your criminal record, and a whole lot more. I'm board certified in criminal law, and I've been trying cases to juries for over 25 years. I developed this channel for you. This is your source of legal information. For this edition, I'm going to segue a little bit from my usual format and talk about the federal crime of conspiracy. I handle a lot of federal criminal cases, and defending people charged with conspiracy is a big part of what I do. Now, conspiracy is when two or more people agree to commit a crime and one of them takes an affirmative step to commit the crime. One or the other, it doesn't have to be both. Now, just talking about it is not enough. Talk is cheap, it's not illegal. But the minute one person takes the next step to commit the crime, that's when it becomes illegal. And that holds true even if the crime you conspire to commit would be impossible to achieve. Conspiring to commit a crime that would otherwise be impossible to achieve can still land you in jail for a whole lot of years. I'll give you an example. Say the police want to break up a gang and put its members behind bars, but they're having trouble catching them in the act. What they do is they send in an undercover cop posing as a drug dealer. The undercover cop tells them, "Hey guys, I know where there's a stash house with 50 kilos of cocaine in it." He tells them, if he provides them with the address of the stash house and they go rob it for him, he'll split the proceeds with them 50-50. He provides the information and they do the robbery. So they all agree and they meet at a prearranged location and they get ready to do the robbery. Now, once they get to this location with their guns and their masks and they're ready to go, that's when the undercover officer gives a signal, the police force swoops in and arrests the whole bunch of them. This is known as a sting operation. Now, the ironic part is, there never was a stash house, and there never was 50 kilos of cocaine. It was all totally made up. Now, it would have been impossible for these guys to commit the crime because it didn't exist. It was just a complete fiction on the part of the police. The details were created by the police to catch a group of criminals before they act. Now, you may be wondering, how can they be convicted of a crime that is impossible to commit? It's because they were charged with conspiracy to commit the crime, not actually committing the crime. And it doesn't matter that the crime could not have been committed. The conspiracy is the crime they committed. Conspiracy is what they violated. They agreed to commit the crime and they took steps in preparation to do it. And that's all you need for a conspiracy. This is why the government loves conspiracies, because they're easier to prove and they can catch criminals before they act. And this may give those of you who are interested in criminal law something to think about. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this little segue from my usual format, and I'll be back next time with another edition of The Fedora Lawyer. Until then, this is The Fedora Lawyer signing off.